These are not reliable historical accounts. There are too many discrepancies. Who went to the tomb on the third day? Did Mary Magdalene go alone, or did Mary go with other women? Depends which gospel you read. If with other women, how many of them were there? What were their names, and which ones were they? It depends which gospels you read.
Many skeptics, both atheists and Muslims, will try to point out that the differences in the four gospel accounts, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, are contradicting each other when informing us on how many women first discovered the empty tomb of Jesus. Now, there are differences, but not contradictions. So let's tackle this objection by first looking at the relevant passage in each of the four gospel accounts. In Matthew, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary are mentioned specifically by name. In Mark, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome are mentioned specifically by name, as they were also in chapter 15 at the crucifixion. Luke is mentioning specifically by name Mary Magdalene, Joanna, and Mary the mother of James, same as he did in his previous chapter, where he also is referring a few times to a group of women followers of Jesus. Before going to John's account, notice that the synoptic gospels, Matthew, Mark, and Luke, sure includes a lot of words such as the women, they, them. And look at, for example, the last two sentences from that passage in Luke's account. And I quote, "And they remembered his words, and returned from the tomb, and reported all these things to the 11 and to all the rest. Now they were Mary Magdalene, and Joanna, and Mary the mother of James. Also the other women with them were telling these things to the apostles." End quote. Which gives plenty of room for that there were more women at the tomb than the three Luke specifically mentioned by name. Now the gospel according to John, which is the account dated to have been written the latest out of the four, only mentions Mary Magdalene specifically by name. But before Skeptic says, aha, keep in mind what we just went through in the three synoptic gospels, and the fact that John does not write only Mary Magdalene came to the tomb. If John, or any of the other gospel authors, did that about their specifically mentioned names in their accounts, then that would have been a contradiction. But none of them do that. Far from it, actually. Including John's account, which may look like that he only leaves room for Mary Magdalene at first. But not so fast. Pay attention to this important word and sentence when she told the disciples, and I quote, "They have taken away the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him." When Mary Magdalene is talking here, she's not using I, she's using we. And she was in no position to use a royal plural we about herself. A lot more likely would be that we here is referring to the other women with her when discovering the empty tomb, just as the early gospel accounts does. Therefore, also John's account can be harmonized together with Matthew, Mark, and Luke. Regarding the differences, keep also in mind the ancient literary style of spotlighting, which is also done in ancient Greco-Roman biographies outside of the gospels, and the option that the gospel authors may have just played it safe when mentioning the specific names of the women as the eyewitnesses, using only specific names on the persons that they could verify within each of their own communities. Again, yes, there are some differences, but I would just like to say here at the end, isn't that what you would expect when it's different eyewitnesses, different perspectives, different authors that have different backgrounds, highlighting different points from the different given accounts? The gospel writers cared about the truth, and they were not under some obligation to write according to a criteria and rule that skeptics set for them 2000 years later. They wrote it as it was. Even the embarrassing fact of having women, and in ancient times, as the heroes and the first eyewitnesses in the story. That's not how you sell a religion in ancient times, by the way. And with the exception of Luke, the gospel writers were all Jewish believers in Yahweh, already believing that they were God's chosen people. They did not make this thing up. The New Testament writers did not create the resurrection. The resurrection created the New Testament writers.